So right here is a good example of how to use one of these shortcuts. I'm going to model it for you, but I would like you to pause it between steps and see if you could figure it out. Now, looking at the givens, it tells me that D is the midpoint of AB. Okay, well, what that does is it kind of splits two things, a segment to two congruent parts. And I also know that it tells me that AC is congruent to CB. Now we got to figure out, is it side, 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 or side, angle, side? Well, both triangles physically share CD. So I got three pairs of sides that are congruent. I'm going to write that. I'm going to, just as like an outline, I'm going to prove these triangles by side, side, side congruence. Okay, so let's get started. I'll use the first part of the given. The first given, D is the midpoint of AB. Okay, and that's given information. And we're going to use this result right away. This tells me, because it's the midpoint, I can say that AD is congruent to BD. And the reason for that is what a midpoint does, and a midpoint divides a segment into two congruent parts. And I want to make a note. What I'm going to do is I'm going to write side next to this and box it in just to remind me I got one of my pieces of information. The next thing is, well, I do know that AC is congruent by CB because they told me or they gave me that information. So this is also given. And again, this is another side I need to find. Okay. And now looking at it, I also know that CD is congruent to itself, CD, right? And the reason is, well, a segment is congruent to itself, also known as the reflexive property. And I have the third piece of information, side. Check it out. I have now three pieces of information I need. I could state that these triangles are congruent. So let's do that. The last step is this. So five, triangle ACD is congruent to triangle BCD. A corresponds to B. That makes sense. Good. C corresponds, both triangles have C in it as one of the vertexes of their angle. And D is one part here. And the vertex D is used here. Okay, yeah, this works. So these triangles are congruent by side, side, side congruence. And we're done with the proof.